you like my videos, make sure to go ahead and click subscribe. Once you do, hit that little bell icon so you're notified whenever I upload. Also, comment I subscribe down below and you will automatically be entered into my monthly shoutout giveaway. Now, let's get on with this video. Yesterday was a pretty sad day for me, and I imagine many others who currently reside in the good old United States. Most of you know, I'm a pretty big fan of TikTok. I've made a few TikToks of my own in the past, and it's honestly become part of my daily routine before I go to bed to just scroll through the app for at least 30 minutes, if not longer. Who am I kidding? So I might have a minor addiction, but if it makes you happy, it can't be all that bad, right? Well, I think most of us would agree with that statement, aside from our current president, Mr. Donald Trump. The internet slightly blew up yesterday, with countless people scared that the popular app we all know and love could soon be reaching its end in the United States. And even if some of you out there aren't that big of a fan of it, you should at least know how many people that would affect. Yes, for a lot of people, TikTok just seems like a stupid app for kids, but it really goes beyond that. There's huge communities of people on it, just like there is for YouTube, including a pretty large Roblox community, which I also thoroughly enjoy, and I imagine a lot of you watching do as well. Not only that, but there are a lot of people in the United States who work on developing updates for the app who will be without a job if Trump does decide to go through with deleting it. Not only that, but a lot of self-starter businesses rely on sales that are driven through TikTok, influencers obviously heavily rely on TikTok, and just in general, it's always been such a good app to help you get your social media presence off of the ground since the algorithm really helps highlight smaller people in order to get them noticed. But what is the reasoning behind Trump wanting to ban what seems to be a fairly harmless app? There's quite a few theories that are going around right now. The first being that since the app originated in China, the creators could be using it to take information from every person on the app. I'm no expert by any means, but I do know that basically with any app or social media platform, programs have the ability to study the type of content you're watching the most of, to in turn either show you ads for items that you'd most likely be interested in buying, or for an app like TikTok, to curate your For You page with content that it thinks you will enjoy. So, this theory isn't unreasonable by any means, however, the creators of TikTok have come forward and basically said, "We don't track any of your information," which I'd like to believe, but they obviously do to an extent to curate the content we're seeing. Do I think this is reason enough to delete the app? No, but I do understand the reasoning behind this theory. Another theory is a bit more personable to Donald Trump as the president, and to explain this one, I'll be reading from an article on Forbes.com where they write about the effect that TikTok had on one of Trump's campaigns. In June, Trump announced he wanted to have a rally in Tulsa on June 19th, a day celebrated as a holiday commemorating the end of slavery. Trump's decision to have it that day, in a city with a painful, violent history of racism, angered people, and in the end, he relented, somewhat moving it to the next day. His decision did not stop a campaign that quickly formed on TikTok and Twitter in mid-June, about a week before the rally. Its goal was pretty straightforward: flood the Trump website for reserving tickets with fake names, phone numbers, and emails, and then never attend the rally. Theoretically, it would give the Trump campaign false hopes for a large crowd leading up to the event and make them look foolish when it was sparsely attended. And it kinda worked! The movement went viral worldwide and people from all over the world signed up to attend the rally. However, it ended up being only filled to about a third of the way. According to the article, the Trump campaign publicly blamed it on the protests, however, reporters said that there were few protests happening that night. So, that's another theory behind why Trump may want the app gone, because it's clearly a bit powerful. Not to like get political or anything, but I do know a good chunk of people on the app do not support the president, so it's understandable why having a platform against him would make him nervous. I don't personally think that this has anything to do with the actual supposed removal of the app, however, I won't rule it out of the realm of possibilities. So, what exactly did Trump say yesterday that has everyone up in arms about him deleting the app? We can head over to CNBC.com and their article where they quoted some of his comments made while the president was on a flight back to Washington from Florida. He said, "As far as TikTok is concerned, we're banning them from the United States," Trump said, calling the action a severance. Trump did not specify whether he will act through an executive order or another method, such as designation, according to NBC News. "Well, I have that authority. I can do it with an executive order or that," Trump said. The article continued to say, "A TikTok spokesperson told NBC News that the app helped to create jobs across the US and was committed to user privacy. We've hired nearly 1,000 people to our US team this year alone, and we are proud to be hiring another 10,000 employees into great-paying jobs across the US." The spokesperson said in a statement, "Our $1 billion creator fund supports US creators who are building livelihoods from our platform." TikTok user data is stored in the US with strict controls on employee access, the statement said. "TikTok's biggest investors come from the US. We are committed to protecting our users' privacy and safety as we continue working to bring joy to families and meaningful careers to those who create on our platform." So, like I said, a lot of people depend on TikTok for their livelihoods and to pay their bills every month. The app getting deleted affects a huge chunk of people in the United States, so this goes a bit beyond just deleting some silly app. I will say though, even though all of this information has been made public, we still have a glimmer of hope that TikTok will stay with us. Yesterday, I received a notification from the app, which was a message to the TikTok community, where they explained that they didn't plan on going anywhere, and basically what I've already explained in this video. They provide jobs, and they don't take private information. So, fingers crossed that TikTok will stay around, not only to cure all of our boredom, but also for the sake of all the people who depend on it. Let me know your guys' thoughts on all of this down below. Do you personally think Trump will really go through with deleting the app? Anyways, I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, as per usual, make sure to leave a like, subscribe because I'm trying to hit 200,000 subscribers super soon, and comment once you do in order to be entered into my monthly shoutout giveaway. That's it for me. I hope you all have an awesome rest of your day. Stay safe, and I will see you in the next video.